Dear people, what you have to understand is that Father's given you a special anointing. He's given you a special anointing so that you could be privileged to be the source of that mighty river and that mighty stream. Let me just tell you this. Any person that calls themselves a minister of the gospel and they're willing to stand by and watch the church be anything less than glorious, I question their love. I question their revelation. I question their calling into this glorious church. Because I'm telling you, Father made a church glorious with the baptism in the Holy Ghost and fire, in which the manifestation of the Holy Spirit is given to every person. And people say, oh, why must there be correction? Oh, mercy rejoices over judgment. My goodness, when the thing is so stinking messed up, it's got to be corrected from the crown of its head to the sole of its foot. All somebody's got to do is look and see that there is no hinderer of iniquity. And if there was, things would not be developing and eroding as they are. And I know that my God in heaven, my heavenly Father, has purposed that there should be a great outpouring of His Spirit in these last days. He's purposed that His Son should be magnified and glorified. And let me just tell you, there is no glorious church without the manifestation of the Holy Ghost. When the Holy Spirit in being manifest is not present, you only have religion, dead, lifeless, false witness of religion. And people say, just leave us alone. Let us be. But I tell you, listen to me, when you speak to a mountain and it doesn't move, you keep speaking till it's gone. There are those who've been stirred with the passions of the Lord, whose heart has been kindled and knit together with His. Hallelujah. Kindled with His fire, made one with Him. And Father's going to labor to bring forth that glorious church that Jesus purchased with His own blood. You listen to me. We contend. That means we enter into a struggle, a battle for the faith that was once delivered unto the saints. We understand that there is no glorious church unless there is the functioning of those office gifts that are mentioned in 1 Corinthians chapter 12, where He put apostles, where He placed prophets and teachers and the working of miracles and the gifts of tongues and interpretation of tongues, along with governments and helps. You will not come into this meeting one single night and not behold the way that God put in His church tongues and interpretation of tongues. You will not come in this place and not see the works of the Lord Jesus Christ. I mean, I praise the Lord for all the things that He's done, but I'm telling you right now, I know that there is a place that Father labors to bring His church to, where the works of Jesus Christ on that scale is being seen in greater works. And it's all about a relationship with the Father. He said, just before He said that in verse 12 of John chapter 14, He said, it's the Father that is in me that does the works. Believe me for my very work's sake. And then He says, and these works, anyone who believes. I'm going to tell you right now, I know that it takes hunger and it takes thirsting. It takes zeal and it takes passion to be zealous. I mean, where these things keep you awake at night, where it's more important to you than your necessary food. Father is going to bring forth His precious fruit of the earth, His sonship glory that He gave to us when He rose up from the dead. When He gave to us this glorious power that His redemption at Calvary wrought. When we, by miracle, were crucified together with Him, and by miracle, as it were, descended down into hell with Him, being buried with Him by baptism into His death. By miracle, we were raised up together with Him and we're alive together with Him. And by miracle, seated with Him in a place that is far above all principalities and powers and might. Tonight I'm going to talk to you about what it means to live in the Spirit and walk in the Spirit, because God wants and God has to have people of the Spirit in His church. And I'm going to tell you right now, there are preachers watching in different places in the United States right now. And I have a witness among a great majority of Holy Ghost Pentecostal preachers that people of the Spirit are far and few between. We've got a lot of people who know about mental ascent. They live in the mentality of humanity. I'm telling you, but God wants you to learn how to walk in the authority of the Word of the Spirit, to live in the Word of the Spirit and the life of the Spirit. That's what we're here laboring to bring to pass. I'm not here for people to gather unto me because I'm a good storyteller. I'm not here to have some kind of a religious thing going down. We are here and placed here by the sovereign power, the living God, the Almighty, whose name is sovereign, who is jealous, whose name is jealous, for a purpose of bringing a change, of shifting the thing around, that there is a witness among humanity, that there are those who seek God, not mammon, who are not interested in the things that would please the humanity of our lives. We're desperately interested in the heavenly that has been brought to us through this new birth. I want you to understand, there is nothing as easy as giving a message in tongues and interpreting them. It's just being a person of the Spirit. It's as easy as breathing. I don't really spend a lot of time talking to people about how to flow in the gift. I usually just talk to them about the things that hinder them from flowing in the gift, because it's just a gift. God gave the Holy Ghost as a gift. And many people just keep Him shut up in their life, and it's about time you understand how to release Him. It's about time you understand how to yield to Him. And I'm blessed. I'm praising God for all of the growth in different people's lives, but I'm interested in the fullness of that which creation, I said which creation, groans and travails right now. Which Father, listen, when Father said, as many as are led by the Spirit, they are the sons of God, you do not any longer have the spirit of bondage to fear, to live under intimidation and live under the yoke of human self-consciousness. But I have given you the Spirit of the Son, whereby you say, I am the offspring of the Almighty. Or in other words, you say, Abba, Father, my dad is my dad. And in that context, Paul began to talk about that which all creation groans and travails to see, this glorious manifestation, this glorious liberty, this glorious freedom, this glorious release that comes wherever the manifest sons of God are. And he's talking about the manifest sons of God simply being those who are led by the Spirit, those who walk in the Spirit. We're talking about the Holy Spirit, those who have been, who've been filled up with Him. He's with them and He's in them. The biggest need for people is to understand how to stop the mentality, the thoughts and the imaginations. But there's only one way. You have to be filled with the Spirit. Ha ha. Ha ha. Woo. When you learn how to begin to rejoice and give thanks instead of asking God, oh God, what's wrong with me? These doubt and faithless, intimidated, under the power of fear prayers. And you start rejoicing in Him and saying, oh Lord, You're so wonderful. All that You've done for me. When you begin to move out of the realm of condemnation and guilt and shame, then you can begin to be corrected. As long as people live under the oppression of condemnation and guilt and shame and harassment of demon power and the oppression of human mentality, trying to figure it all out, mentally trying to get it done, do not know how to be people of the Spirit. You can't even take the first step of instruction from the Lord. It's too much. Why? Because He's talking to us about living God's life, not our life. Hallelujah. Living the very life of God Almighty. That is eternal life. John personified eternal life. He said, the eternal life was manifested unto us, and we've seen him, and we reveal him, or manifest, or make him known unto you. He personalized and personified Jesus Christ, the eternal life. And Jesus said, I want to give you my life. This is, he gave to us an anointing to dwell in his life. We don't need anyone to teach us this about what God has purposed, because the anointing that we've received of him teaches us that we are to dwell in him, to have our whole existence and life in him. But religion won't let you. You can be seated. Religion won't let you. People have become so fascinated talking about religion. Now people are, you know, religious about not being religious. It's just wild. I want you to understand that Father is laboring to bring forth something that he will absolutely have. Father will absolutely have a precious fruit of the earth that James talked about in James 5:7, and I'm laboring for it. Father has a glorious church which he has washed with the water of his word. And I want to talk to you about that, because listen, people, I've noticed that folks do not walk in the spirit of the word. They do not walk in the word of the spirit. They're there for a little while, but they don't live there. You know, when the Lord Jesus sent the disciples, you can read about this in Matthew chapter 14 is one of the places. But when he sent the disciples across the sea and they got in that boat, they went by direct orders by the word of the Spirit. Now, you must understand, these are men who are seamen. They know about the winds and they know about the currents. And their rational mind and their rational thinking said to them, listen, all we've got to do is turn around and go back to the shore and wait for the calm. It'll come in the morning, and then we can be immediately across, and we'll probably get across quicker that way than if we continue on this way. Because if we continue on this way, by the time the storm lets up, we're going to be tired. And so if we go rest up, we can sit around the campfire, we get eat a little fish, get a little nap, then get back in the boat. I mean, this is all sensible. It's all the mentality of men. It's all the imagination and the human interest and the logic and the rationalization of men. It's all the mental ascent of trying to figure out how it works. We've watched this take place since the charismatic movement took in hostage the glorious church. With all of their imaginations trying to say, this is how the moving of the Spirit happens. The moving of the Holy Ghost is like the currents of the water. He comes to us like rushing streams of irresistible force and power. When you come to a place of yieldedness and submission to him, you're swept away by this divine power and glory. Hallelujah. Even as they were on the day of Pentecost. Swept away, I'm telling you. Hallelujah. It's time that people come to recognize and come to realize that they've been walking in human mentality. They've been walking in a relationship with God based upon mental ascent and not after the Spirit. Out of the exercises of human power, trying to earn the gifts that God has given so freely. The gift of the Holy Ghost being the most spectacular of all. The gift of righteousness being right up there with it. The gift of holiness. It's a gift. It's ours. It's just given. Praise God. All you have to do is begin to walk in the spiritual laws of life. I was crying out to the Lord about these things, and the Spirit of the Lord gave me this word through tongues and interpretation of tongues. I like many of the things that happen in my life come by way of tongues and interpretation of tongues. Much of the ministry that we participate in is there. It's also the same place that prophecy works, also the same place that revelation works. It's the force of the Holy Ghost. And I want to share this with you. I'm going to read this to you, even though there's some of you that follow me on Facebook, you probably already read these things, because I like to get it right up there. But before I read this, I just want to say, not only did they refuse to walk and their mental reasoning, and that which sounded very sensible, that which seemed to be no different from what Christ Jesus told them, other than it is different, even though they were at risk of their own life and putting their own life to risk, even though they had left before it was even dark, and now it's the fourth watch, which means it's somewhere between 3 o'clock in the morning and 6 o'clock in the morning, which means they've now been rowing for somewhere between 7 and 9 hours. And they've only gone on about 3 miles, about halfway. They did not stop walking in the word of the Spirit. And tonight I'm going to talk to you, and I want you to grab a hold of these things, and I want you to react, interact with God. And I'm going to tell you right now, when you begin to get overwhelmed, you need to just get up and dance a little bit. You just need to get up and rejoice. You need to get up and start shouting about the good things of God. Take a lap. Take a run. Begin to be interactive. Because I'm telling you, Southern California is oppressed by demon spirits that has put everybody under the authority of a gag order. People cannot speak. And when they speak, you hear humanity. You do not hear heaven. And I, along with you, many of you, and along with those of the church, are contending for a revival. But before there's a revival, there has to be a turning back to God. Revivals do not come. You do not step back into the inheritance that has been given until you turn your heart back to Him to say, okay, Lord, we're going to do it your way. We fashion the meeting after our way, after the things that we want. People do not believe it, but the church is filled with rebellious children in whom the ways of the Lord do not exist. And I guarantee you, listen to me, when Jesus talked to you the way he did to the Pharisees, and John talked to the way he did to the Pharisees, they could not even imagine how they could possibly be saying that about them in view of their devotion. But listen, tonight, I want you to grab a hold of God. I want you to grab a hold of the Holy Spirit. I want you to understand we're not giving to you apple cider vinegar here tonight. Come on, we're giving you some. Come here to the sweet table of the Lord. Come sit here and interact with the Holy Ghost. One of the first big problems is that people think that everybody's just like them, and it's man speaking from the pulpit. They don't give place to God, the Holy Ghost, speaking expressly as an oracle. I mean, I'm telling you, in the Old Testament, God primarily made his word known unto the prophets. He's put his word in my mouth and also in my heart. Hallelujah. Even the word of faith. Hallelujah. And all you got to do is start interacting with God instead of interacting with man. Stop taking it as ridicule and insult and start taking it as instruction and correction to understand the things that you're going to have to say no to, the things you're going to have to not deny and resist steadfast in the faith, the places you're going to have to grab a hold of yourself and say, wait, I'm not living that way anymore. God's called me to come and live in the Spirit, have and walk in the mind of the Holy Ghost and walk in the mind of Jesus Christ. It's not hard to do. In fact, it's very easy to do. Oh, once you begin to enjoy the relationship of it. But you know, nonetheless, the Lord did very pointedly talk about the weapons of our warfare not being carnal, but God power, mighty through God, to deal with the issues of walking in the human mentality, walking in the human assent and reasoning, which makes void the power of God, which makes void the workings of the Holy Ghost, which is absolutely impossible for the Holy Spirit or the mind of Christ or the mind of the Spirit to agree with. It's a realm of divine goodness that has been granted to us by the sweet and precious ministry of the word of the Lord that has been given to us, in which we come to you with, and we declare these things. And listen, I don't want to have to chew this thing down. I just need you to turn it up. Making known to you that which is a miracle power right now. And when you begin to walk out in the miracle power of God, are you going to encounter resistance? Absolutely. That is exactly why the Lord says you must be filled with the Spirit. And that is a continual ongoing being filled. It's a continual ongoing being baptized. I was sitting with a bunch of ministers one day, and I said, so what's the difference between being filled and baptized? And some people started to raise their hand, so I said, quickly, nothing. There's none.
Because the Lord Jesus said in Acts 1:5, you shall be filled. In Acts 2:4, they were baptized. In Acts 1:5, you should be baptized. In Acts 2:4, when they were baptized, the scripture just simply says they were filled. Somebody said, well, that's not what it means in the Old Testament. Well, I got news for you. We're not in the Old Testament. It's the New Testament. And things are redefined different, okay, on many levels. And you're just going to have to understand this. You're just going to have to recognize that the only way that you and I are going to walk in the strength of the Lord and the power of his might to take unto ourselves the whole armor of God, that we may deal with the wiles, the tricks of Satan, because we wrestle not. I mean, in a conflict, I'm talking about a wrestling, not a sniper event, not a boxing match, a wrestling match. It takes a lot more to wrestle, dealing with the hand-to-hand conflict, as it were, because it comes down to that level of intensity in our life against spiritual wickedness, against authorities in high places. And Father has given to us the ability that he himself has, that he has given and empowered Christ Jesus to the fullness of when he set him at his own right hand, far above all principalities and powers and might and dominion. And above every name that is named, not only in this world, but also in the world to come. You must understand, you're going to have to hide away in Jesus, because the rebellious imp called Satan is going to come and make sure that he sows strife, discord, envy, and every other little thing he can possibly plant in there, so that you may not have the mind of the Spirit and you may not have the mind of Christ, and you're going to walk in human mentality and human reasoning, and you're going to be overwhelmed by and seeded by the seeds of fear and intimidation, and you will ultimately come to a place where you will not be corrected. God's children are chastened. Hallelujah. They're instructed of the Lord. And every time the Lord gives an instruction, he has his anointing is there. If you reach out and take a hold of it, if you are not rebellious children, if you're not children who receive correction wrong, but you take a hold of that wonderful correction and instruction of the Lord, right there is the gift of the Spirit. Right there is the release of God. Right there is the maturity, the empowerment of the living God for you now to take a hold of and begin to have that which you were not born with. Hallelujah. In the natural respect, you weren't born with it. When we were born of the Holy Ghost, we were blessed with all spiritual blessings in the heavenly places. Of his fullness we received. And Paul even describes that we actually, Jesus said, we receive sonship at that moment in time. We have the authority to walk as sons, and that is only described in Christ Jesus, the Son. We understand that it is not like a child, it's fully matured sons in the sense that all that Father has is made available to us. But I guarantee you, you must mature, you must grow. And that's only going to be a possibility by you sincerely desiring the word of the Spirit. You hungry for the word of God. His word enters into you and it is a delight unto you. I mean, I want to see the word of God enter into somebody tonight. And I know when it goes in, it's going to cause you to delight. Hallelujah. You're going to receive the word with joy. It's going to be inside of you a joy and rejoicing. Those who know the joyful sound. Hallelujah. Amen. And that's really the way it needs to be. When you begin to do that, just like you are doing right now, you are actually making yourself available to the vocal gifts of the Holy Ghost. You are responding to him. You're not any longer operating under an oppressive demon spirit who would produce a gag order upon your life so that the Spirit of the Lord, the rivers of God, cannot flow forth from you. You're going to have to understand that demon spirits are trying to stop up the well. I mean, I'm going to tell you right now, Satan comes. He has nothing in me. But I've watched where that's not true for many of God's people, because they're not people of the Spirit. They're people of human mentality and human mental ascent. They do not know how to live by and walk in the Holy Ghost and depend upon him. It's so easy. Hallelujah. It's so rich and so free. It's so wonderful.
Hallelujah.
And then you get to bring your best when you come to the meeting. Yes. The best of what you know in God. The best. Hallelujah. Because he's building us up together in him. He's the chief cornerstone. He's made us living stones. And we're built together to offer as a holy habitation, to offer up praise that's acceptable unto the Father by Christ Jesus. But people aren't allowing that. The body of Christ is not revealed until the manifestation of the Spirit begins to happen in each individual's life. And that's not something you practice. That is something that you come under the force of because you yielded to Him. You're obeying Him and walking with Him and being taught of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He begins to activate your emotions and your passions like nothing else can. Some people listen to a comedian, they just can't stop laughing because that activates their emotions. It does not activate mine. Huh? I don't see any humor in it, but I'm going to tell you right now, Now hold up, listen, you don't understand. That is a tongue to be interpreted. And you guys are just joining on in a prayer language. Huh? In the utterance of the tongue of the issue, you don't understand. God wants to give you understanding. And then you can actually, as understanding, if you're in the same spirit of that and under the same force of that, you will actually have the same utterance coming out, but with the understanding. The same, as it were, the same prophetic anointing that would be upon you to prophesy comes upon you to so as even it is naturally to interpret that. And we show it and we model it, but what you're going to have to understand is you're going to have to honor the anointing. You're going to have to honor the place of the anointing. The people who lead you, they've got to have something in their life that you want.
Yes.
And if they don't, you need to go find somebody that's got something in their life that you want.
Yes.
Then you can honor them and you can hook up with them and you can easily receive.
Yes.
You know, when I go with other ministers, I go to places with other ministers, there are various different dimensions of the operation of the gifts of the Spirit that are unique to the way that I normally function in the Holy Ghost that I'll come under just because I honor them, I'm with them, I love being with them, I love the anointing in their life, I want what they've got, and more. You know, I'm like the Elisha in the thing. I want double what you got kind of thing. I'm not going to go for it. I'm not selling out short. And I'm setting my sights high. I'm sold out for everything, you see. I'm sold out for the whole thing. And of His fullness have all we received. But I'm going to tell you right now, you've got to mature in it because I'm telling you, there are those who are like children because they still walk in the carnality of human mentality. And that's what Paul said. And my goodness, at least they had great leaders like Peter and Apollos. I guarantee you, they weren't religious folks. They were Holy Ghost people. But some saying, I'm a Paul, I'm a Apollos, I'm a Cephas. Said, you're just carnal. You have not even begun to know yourself after the Spirit yet. And if you haven't begun to know yourself after the Spirit, listen to me right now, then you're under the legislation of the spirit of this world is influenced about comparisons, competitions, and complaints. But once you know yourself after the Spirit, you do not know yourself after the flesh anymore. You don't know yourself after the one that mama and daddy made and that glorious relationship of love that Father brought them together in. But you know yourself having now been born of the Father, born of the Word, born of the Spirit, born of the resurrection. Now you see yourself different. You think about yourself different. Now you're wide open to receive. I have God put within my spirit this anointing to labor to help people understand that they do not have to have a guilty conscience anymore. That they don't have to feel other than God anymore. That He's given us His glory. He's made us one with Him. He's given us the new creation, the new nature, a divine nature. He's filled us with His Spirit. Made us one spirit with Him. So that they can begin to build on a solid foundation. Not continue on in fear and intimidation. And human mentality and mental ascent. You're going to have to learn how to step over in the Holy Ghost. There's too many songs that are sung in church that were written by some skinny jeans musician with a beer in one hand and a guitar in the other. I want nothing to do with that stuff.
I'm interested in the things of the Spirit. People know about sensationalism because they walk more after their five senses than they know about the anointing, which is interacting with an unseen realm, moving in a dimension that is only possible to do because you were born into it, and now you hunger for it more than anything else. You thirst for it more. You're zealous for it. I'm not telling you, you can't live without it. It's more important than your drink and your food. Passions are all wrapped up in it. You can't live without it. Oh, that's what God demands. And it's good because it's so rich, it's so beautiful. Even though it's so free and it's so liberally given, it's still so sacred. And it's got to be more important to you than anything else, otherwise you're going to violate the sacredness of it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But look at the faithfulness. There they are, the wind and the wave. The thread of their life is at stake. They're going in the spirit of the word. They're going to walk in the word. Hallelujah. They've been sent forth in the word of the spirit. They're under the spirit of the word. They're under the force of the power of the word of the living God. Hallelujah. They will not bend. They will not bow. They will not move. We go into the other side. And they have shut down all that they know and the reasonings of their seamanship and the reasonings of their human mentality. They shut down all of the logics of a human ascent that ultimately would easily kick in. They have denied it. They have committed themselves to this is what Christ Jesus, he constrained them, he commanded them, he ordered them, he would not give them any wiggle room. Get in the boat and go now. And that's all they could hear. Listen to me. Listen to me. I mean, I want you to get rejoicing and I want you to get happy, but I would rather hear you say, yes, Lord, bring it, than hear a goo goo gaga in tongues. Okay? I don't want to just, it'd be better for you to speak after the language that you understand of just, Lord, I love you. Yes, God, I want that. I'm hearing that. Okay, Father, I'm changing. Yes. Come on now. And if you don't know how to do anything else, raise your hand. Get up and dance a little bit. Get yourself into a place of movement. Because I'm telling you, the word of God is going forward. And if it hits you, it's going to create a joy. It's going to create a joy. Listen to me. Come on. God, the Father, loves his children, but it's time that he has some matured sons. It's time that those that are Father, we are laborers together with his husbandry. He is the husbandman of John 15 that is laboring to bring forth as the husbandman, a precious fruit of James chapter 5:7, which is that fully matured, manifested, glorious working of Christ Jesus in you and me. That full revelation of all that he gave to us when he made us one with him. Listen to me, people. Listen to me. Hello. Kambanjaya karameya. Come on now. Hallelujah. Listen, don't you get into that human mentality. Don't get into that mental ascent. I want to talk to your spirit, not your head. I'm not interested in communicating with your intellect. I try to tell you again and again, you have to enter his courts with praise, and you have to enter his gates with thanksgiving. I've already told you can only come into this realm by the blood of Jesus. I told you can only have access into this realm by the Spirit of truth. It's time that God's people go ahead and take their place as sons that are born of the Spirit, who live in the Spirit, who walk in the Spirit, who know how to interact with the Holy Ghost, who know how to be sensitive to him, who know how to respond to him, who know how to step over into this realm, who've got enough anointing to overcome the tired state of their body. You know, the Lord was talking to me about so many people. They've never come into the roar. They've never come into the cry. They've never come into the force of the Holy Ghost. They basically only have a little whisper when they speak in tongues because the influence of their body is still greater than the influence of the Spirit. It's at like an equilibrium. You're going to have to move into a place where there becomes something that is greater in sound than your throat. Ha, hallelujah. Ha, 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 ha. Hallelujah. where the busting forth of the presence of God. And these things will happen in a hunger and a thirst and a zealousness for spiritual gifts. Hallelujah. I'm telling you right now, you listen to me. They will just explode in you overnight when the passion is right. Get rid of the leaven and you're going to have heaven. I'm going to tell you, they'll explode on the inside of you when the passion is right. Like overnight. You don't have to wait years. You just got to come under the rod. You got to make God sovereign. You got to make Holy Ghost ruler. Not just Lord, because that's gotten all filtered. Huh? Master, ruler, sovereign governor.
Hallelujah. Makaya, Shaya, Maya, Taya, Bocha, Maya, Tana. Hallelujah. Bocha, Mana, Tana, Ikeno. Hallelujah. Pangadea. Hakanamea. Hakanamea. Hakanamea te stalape. You know, I was going to say a few minutes ago, I mean, listen, you ought to be so close to joy and rejoicing. You should be so close.
Woohoo! Woohoo!
You get up, dance a little bit. Get up, dance a little bit. Just get up, dance a little bit. Just get up, dance a little bit. Come on, I'm telling you right now.
Yeah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Woohoo!
Okay, give me a minute. Give me a minute.
Woohoo!
Go ahead, sit down for a second. Go ahead, sit down for a second. Just sit down for a second. I mean, I just praise God for the responsiveness. I was actually talking to Leslie, but, you know, because I'm going to tell you right now, if you would just begin to react to your situations of life by beginning to celebrate and rejoice in Him. I mean, that's, we try to say it over and over again at the expense of constantly talking about ourselves. I'll testify again. This is what we do. Turn me up. This is what we do. If something starts trying to come out against us, it's contrary or different from the word of the Spirit, we get up and start moving in God. We get up and start rejoicing in the Lord. Woo! We make our delight, our boast in our God. We give ourselves to thanksgiving and rejoicing. That's where the feeling comes from. The infilling comes from. That's where we shut down all the human mentality, all of the reasoning and logics of men, and all the seeds that Satan would try to sow. And this works in every dimension, not only in the realms of the things and the gifts and the callings of God upon our life, but the things that concerning our health and concerning our finances. It touches every part of our lives. We walk in the word of the Spirit, in the word of authority that has been given from above. Hallelujah. I know that it sounds really good. Your explanations, just about anybody would agree with you. You are smart. That is sound reasoning. Turn the boat around and wait till the morning. Get yourself some rest. You've been at it all night anyways. The Lord will understand. He loves us more than anything we can imagine. Yes, He does. But there's a big difference between being obedient and disobedient, being faithful and being unfaithful, walking with Him or just casually encountering some things that are convenient for you. You're going to have to fix the mic. They're getting carried away back there. Don't swing the pendulum on us. Hallelujah. Ha ha ha. Can I just get you to get happy? Can I get you to rejoice in the Lord evermore? I mean, I tell you right now, you start rejoicing the Lord continually evermore, you'll pray without ceasing. Hallelujah.
It's just a con. It's a beautiful thing. The Lord has caused us to step into the same relationship that he has with the Father, so that the Father loves him, loves us just like he loves him, and so that we can love one another just like the Father loves Jesus and Jesus loves the Father. So that we could set the Father before us and on our right hand that we should not be moved, so that we could have a sonship relationship that we hear the Father speak and thus we speak, and whatever we see the Father do, we get to do. And it's just the expense of getting out of your human mentality.
Yes.
Your human reasoning and logic. Guess what happens to the disciples? You know what happens to the disciples. They get to see Jesus in a whole nother dimension. I would tell you right now, their faith just got elevated to a whole nother level as they begin to see that Christ Jesus was master over the physical realm. As they begin to do that, which was unheard of. No one had ever done this. No one. This is greater works than the Old Testament. No one had ever done this. He's already been translated many times where he's passed through their hands. But now, no one's ever done this. He's not just walking on the water. He's going up over the high waves. The 5 foot high billows have no impact upon him. He's walking down them. Now he's walking back up them. Ah, hallelujah. You know, it's a beautiful picture. It's a beautiful picture because they were headed to Bethsaida across the sea. And we know that they were pointed west. And so now it's somewhere at the fourth watch. It's probably about the time that the sun should rise. But here comes the sun with a bright beaming light of his divine glory. And they get to see it for one reason. They get to see it for one reason. They didn't walk in human mentality. They didn't walk in their reason, their understanding, those things that they could easily self-justify and explain away and get God to agree with, because after all, we've been rowing all night and we've only gone about three miles, maybe only 2.8, depending on how your calculator works. Listen, I'm going to tell you, dear people, you know, as I was getting ready to say a few minutes ago, the joy, the overflow ought to be right there. I mean, but you shouldn't be so embossed, cocooned, shackled, enshelled, oppressed, engrossed with all the things that are going around you in this world, all the offenses, all of the issues, all the cares, that you've got to spend hours in prayer to get a little bubble up. That somebody with a mighty anointing has to labor over you, preach over you, and pray over you till the glory can come by the end of the meeting. So that then you can go back to the things you've been living in that has imprisoned you against the glory. It's talking to the Father. I'm just talking to the Father right now. Should always be there. If it's not there when you get up in the morning, it's like you're not breathing. People would be concerned of you in the morning if you weren't breathing. If you laid there lifeless and part of your face was starting to droop, people would be extremely concerned. They would call the doc. I'm extremely concerned if I don't wake up. I tell you, this is what God gave to you and me so that we could be perfected by the Holy Ghost. Have you begun in the Holy Ghost to now be perfect by the human mentality, by the mental ascent, by the strength of human ability? No. We're perfected by Him, the Holy Ghost. People want to say, people have been lied to in religion, and they think that they don't even understand the language of the Spirit. The language of the Spirit is the gospel. People want to be stuck in Jesus' earthly ministry. Jesus' earthly ministry, we need his earthly ministry. We've got to have his earthly ministry. You don't get to his heavenly ministry without his earthly ministry. We love the earthly ministry. We cry out to God in thanksgiving for the earthly ministry, the cross and the tomb and the resurrection. But he's got a heavenly ministry. It's going on right now. It's called the baptism of the Holy Ghost and fire. And without it, you've got dead religion. And it don't work. The world looks better than dead religion. Huh? Jesus talked to a woman about something that she could drink, and out of her belly would come such a glory, such an ecstasy, such a joy that she wouldn't want the world anymore. She would have just graduated and found out the pleasures that are at his right hand. Hallelujah. But you can't have it because you're casually interested. You're going to have to be born of the Spirit and made alive unto God so that you know what you really want. And then you're going to get desperately hungry for heaven. And this is heaven. God the Holy Ghost brings heaven. Walking in the Spirit is the same as walking in the heavenly. Having days of heaven upon earth. Walking in faith and finding yourself every day growing in intensity and increasing in faith and increasing with the increase of God in your life. That's a manifest presence. I try to tell people I've been hollering for 34 years. I'm going to holler until I die. The more you give yourself to the manifest presence of the Lord, the stronger it becomes. Hallelujah. The more you give yourself to these streams of glory, the greater the force is in your life. You can instantly have joy unspeakable and full of glory. And that's how the Lord wants us to praise Him. That's how He wants us to interact with Him. That's what's supposed to be in the midst of a glorious church. When you are washed with the water of the Word, you get to participate with the glorious church. When you're washed with the water of the Word, you're walking in the Spirit of the Word and the authority of the Word of the Spirit has authority over you, and joy is bubbling up from you. And the love that goes beyond knowledge. And you know what you get out of love that goes beyond knowledge? When you're being strengthened by the Spirit in your inner being, I'm going to tell you what's one of the good things about being strengthened, and you can get strengthened right now, by the way, you just got to reach out and grab it. You just got to let the Word perish you. Hallelujah. Huh? You just got to become sensitive. Well, you're going to be sensitive to the Word when you begin to have a diet of the Word. You live by the Word. When you begin to interact with the Holy Ghost all the time, your senses will be dull if you don't interact with them all the time. Then we got to have to work on you. Get a breakthrough. I'll get the hammer out. Hallelujah. 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 Prakata Moshea. And you should be rejoicing. Hallelujah. I guarantee you, if somebody encased you in concrete and I came towards you with a hammer, you're going, I'm just waiting for you to come. Man, I'm so glad you're here. Get after this thing. Get after this thing. Get this off of me. Hallelujah. Woo! There is a freedom in God. There is a freedom in God. I mean, I just want to give you permission right now. As soon as you're touched by the Holy Ghost, you can hoot, holler, hot dog, hallelujah, anything like that. You can say God is good. You can clap. Yeah, you know, you need to come and feast at the table. This is a feast. This is a feast. This is communion. This is a type. This is only a type of what I am doing right now. I'm eating the flesh. I'm feeding you bread of life right now. I'm giving you a drink indeed right now. The one cup of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Mazaradai. It's sweet. It ain't gonna be bitter. Ain't nobody gonna be spitting that out. Hallelujah. Praise God. I tell you, the bread I'm serving right now is better than them tortillas, too. Even though tortillas make good communion food. It's kind of fleshy, you know. Hurababasia. Hurababasia. His flesh. Halaboshikai. His flesh. Hallelujah. Bakaradaya. Listen, Jesus did nothing of himself. He said it over and over again. It's one of the chief characteristics of sonship. It's one of the chief characteristics of yieldedness to the Holy Ghost, knowing how to shut you down. I said to people one night, oh, I'm so glad I'm not you. And everybody's looking all offended, you know. You should have been offended. You should have been going, me too. And then I had to break it up and say, I'm glad I'm not me either. Now just relax. I mean, get out. There is therefore now no condemnation, no guilt, no shame, no intimidation to those who walk after the Holy Ghost. You know, I pray that you become the most joyous, rejoicing, interactive church, because what's going to happen to you is it ain't going to be long, and all of a sudden, tongues and interpretation of tongues. I know the sound of a message in tongues, I'm telling you. And I'll be quiet quicker than anybody in the place as soon as I hear somebody with that gush, that force.
And I'm telling you, God the Holy Ghost is here with that force. He wants to show you how to move in that glory so that you can be equipped outside to show a world around you a great light that has sprung up in the shadows of darkness, a great light that has sprung up to those who sit in darkness and under the shadows of death. To shine as a light, as a noonday sun. Listen, darkness is over the earth, a gross darkness over.
Because there wasn't anything shining. But God says, go ahead and arise now, for your light has come. Now, people are going to have to understand, there is no light without the manifest of the presence of the Holy Ghost. Jesus said, you'll be false witnesses. God hates a false witness. He said, you cannot be my witnesses. You can't testify of me till you've been received. Tarabakuna machaya pahata. Till you've been endued with power from on high. There is no baptism in the Holy Ghost without that other wonderful declaration of the divine utterance. It doesn't exist. People saying they baptized in the Holy Ghost without tongues, it's like saying they went swimming, didn't get wet. Ain't nobody going to believe that. You shouldn't believe the other. Hallelujah. I just want you to understand. Man, I'm telling you right now, you don't have to walk in sorrow and sadness. You just got to know how to give yourself over to the Holy Ghost and let Him lead you and let Him master you and let Him rule you and let Him take hold of everything a part of your life. And how do you do that? You just begin to give thanks. You begin to worship Him. Hallelujah. Songs and hymns and spiritual songs, sing and make a melody, rejoicing and giving thanks unto God. How difficult is that? It's the force of your will. You got to learn how to get up and dance. You got to learn how to move around. Hallelujah. No matter where you're at. And if you just begin to turn your heart and begin to look to the author and finisher of your faith, all what you're going to happen is you're going to find out that you can live in the mind of Christ and the mind of the Spirit. You can put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh to fulfill its lust, because you simply know how to step over and yield yourself in worship and in praise and in thanksgiving to the living God, to turn to Him. You finally matured enough to recognize the difference between your own influence over you and God the Holy Ghost influence over you. What a great breakthrough. It's true. I love that. I love that. Just go ahead. Just go ahead and grab that. Because I'm telling you, the more excited you get about it, the more you're going to receive. Listen, I never saw anybody receive anything from Jesus that wasn't real excited about it. And when somebody really wanted something, when they were told to shut up, they cried out all the more. Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy upon me. Hallelujah. Hangande eche apahaya. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name. Now, I want to read this to you and real quickly, and then I'm going to go on and start ministering to the things that the Lord put on my heart to share with you. And here's what the Lord gave me. By way of divine utterance. The Lord desires us to continue on from the principles of the doctrine of Christ and mature. That's Hebrews chapter 6:1. Of course, I could put verses of scripture with everything in here, because I examine every word that comes out of my mouth, and I make sure it lines up with at least two verses of scripture. Huh? I'm fallible, but the word's not. Hallelujah. I'm going to go ahead and learn how to speak only by the word of God, because I want to speak only by the Holy Ghost. Don't speak by me. Amen. He would have us drink of the deep waters of the Spirit. That's what's going on here tonight. We in trying to encourage you. Hallelujah. To drink of a realm. It is heavenly. And once you begin to operate in this realm, you find a place now of authority over all other opposing realms and influences, and you become sensitive and very aware of any other kind of influence, and you simply don't allow it. Hallelujah. You get yourself a big picture of a heavenly vision, and God gives you a Holy Ghost insight and revelation, and now you're carrying a mandate from heaven, and it begins to rule your life, and you don't need devotions no more. You don't need discipline anymore, because you surrendered with total abandonment. You under the force and control. Hallelujah. Voluntarily, willingly. Hallelujah. You have access to the Father by the Holy Ghost at any time. Man, when that becomes a wonderful revelation, come on, Geneva, that when that becomes a wonderful revelation, I heard that. It's a spirit. It's a spiritual thing. There, but you've got to start with just any shout, and then before long, it becomes a Holy Ghost utterance. Even a woo becomes a Holy Ghost utterance. It's a sound of heaven. It has a glory in it. It's not just like any other hoot and holler. Hallelujah. It has an inspiration with it. It causes something to begin to stir on the inside of you, you know. Hallelujah. Kambrabaya. Hallelujah. An access, when you begin to recognize your access by the Holy Ghost to the Father, and Father begins to be unveiled to you. See, the Holy Ghost came to reveal Jesus to us, and it is a beautiful thing. And the Lord Jesus is the one who reveals the Father to us. And I'm telling you, it is the most wonderful and exciting place of growth and maturity to begin to look upon Him, to begin to hear His voice, to begin to understand the feelings of His heart, to walk in the passions of His soul. Hallelujah. I said it right, theologians. Email me. To walk in the passions of his soul. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm not so much interested. People sit around and argue whether the Holy Ghost comes on you and remains, or the Holy Ghost stays, how much you can be filled. None of them have any of it. It's about time to get in the big middle of it. It's about time to take the word for what it's for, to receive all that God has given. It's time to now eat the good bread of life, the word of life. It's time to drink deeply of the waters of the Spirit. Hey, the world needs to see a light. The church is the hinderer of iniquity. It's about time we stand up. It's about time we get into the big middle of the fight. It's about time we begin to be a glorious church. Washed with the water of the Word. Like the very wife of the living God. Very companion, the very intimate companion. It's not really wife, not really what we need to say, but it's a mystery. It's an allegory that helps us to express this intimate companion. The church, those redeemed by the blood, brought into the very life of Jesus Christ, made one with Him. You don't exist outside of Him. It's about time you kind of recognize and wake up to it and let God the Holy Ghost measure you up. Instead of saying measure up, let God the Holy Ghost measure you up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He says, the Lord spoke through me and said, to drink of the water of the spirits and begin to function in a greater dimension of sonship, because that's the fruit he's looking for. As many as are received, he gave them the authority to be sons that are heirs, sons, and if sons, then heirs of God, co-inheritors with Christ, not just later, now, these works and greater works, not just later, the heirship of sonship. Did I get to see the Father before me in my right hand that I should not be moved? Did I, whatever the Father says, I speak it. It is the Father now living on me inside of me, doing the work through me. Whatever He does, I do it. Hallelujah. He's speaking in me now. I'm going to tell you right now, if you don't believe that God the Father would speak through a servant, you will never believe that God the Father will speak through you. Hallelujah. It's just like if you won't know yourself after the Spirit, you'll never know anybody else after the Spirit. And God has purposed that we no longer know anyone after the flesh. Not even know Christ Jesus anymore after the flesh. That means after the natural human state of a human being born of a man and a woman. Because you and I were born of the Spirit and elevated into a whole other realm of glory. Sonship glory. Heirship. Hallelujah. Woo! Makarana. Oneness. Oneness. I said oneness with Him. I don't need any grace doctrines that are going to give me permission to sin when I stepped in to this wonderful place of union with Him. When I stepped in to walking out of glory under the power and function and divine ability of the authority of the Holy Ghost, the Spirit of the Son. Hallelujah. 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 Busutaya, 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 Boos. Now I'm speaking right into your spirit with that. I'm speaking right into your spirit. Hallelujah. Busuta hayala. Manda exipano. Anderen ikeataya. Somebody said, I don't need to, I can't understand what he's saying. You can't do much with that anyways. But when God the Holy Ghost is able to touch your spirit, woo! When God is able to touch the realms of that which has produced the very life, body without the spirit is dead. I tell you, the church without the Holy Ghost is dead too. I'm not ashamed of the Holy Ghost any more than I'm not ashamed of Jesus. I want the Holy Ghost. Without the Holy Ghost, Jesus can't be revealed. I want everything he's doing. I want his dance. I want to shout. I want his praise. I want the worship. I want to be drunk in the Holy Ghost. I want to prophesy. I want to walk in the realms of signs and wonders, lay hands on the sick, cast out devils. I want everything that's going down in the heavenly realm that is absolutely destroyed. Every work of Satan, for he is manifested and was manifested to destroy the works of the devil, and he's never stopped, and I'm not going to do anything other than be a part of what he's doing in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Ha 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 ha. Ha 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 ha. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Karama, he is my rock. He is my fortress. He is my deliverer. In him shall I trust. Praise the name. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You don't have to worry about the weight and the sin that would so easily beset you when you know how to look unto the author and the finisher of your faith. The one who began a good work in you, who shall also complete it. He shall bring it to full fruition and maturity. So long as you desperate, hungry, passionate, zealous, can't live without it, gotta have it. Want to be taught the ways of God. Want to live in the realm of the divine. Want to access the Father at any time. Want to live with him continually forever. That's God's people. Ha 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 ha. Ha ha. Hallelujah. 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 Whoa. Ho 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 ho. Ho 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 ho. That's what I do. When all of a sudden the bank account says I don't have enough finances, I go, hallelujah. Woo! I got a mighty, mighty God who reigns forevermore, who gave me everything that he has. Hallelujah. Or any other thing that would come out against us to try to defame what God did when he raised us up together with his only begotten son. When he set us in a heavenly realm. Try and discredit what God did when he set us at his own right hand in the heavenly places. See, that's what Father chose to do. And Salome, James and John didn't understand. They wanted to be at the right and the left. And Jesus said, I can't give it. It's to those that the Father has appointed it for. And then we discovered. Hallelujah. See, what happened was when Paul was on the road to Damascus, he had an encounter with Jesus. Then suddenly, soon thereafter, he had an encounter and a revelation that God had chosen to reveal Christ Jesus in him, that God had chosen to reveal his son in him. Galatians 1:16. Immediately, when he understood the sonship message of the new covenant, he went out into a place, a desert place. Hallelujah. Apart from everybody else. And for 3 years, God downloaded to him the new covenant. God downloaded to him everything that he had done for us when he raised Jesus Christ from the dead And he came in back and wrote it down, and that's about two-thirds of the New Testament. And by and large, it's all about sonship and understanding the spiritual laws of life and understanding how to yield to the Lord and understanding those things which would hinder you from this glorious move of the power of God in your life. Turn me up. Hallelujah. Sakaro botaya tesht. Hallelujah. 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 Hey, a great moving of the Spirit of the Lord is about to take place. Listen, we are laborers together of His husbandry and of His building. It's so long as we are laboring in His husbandry and doing those things and cultivating those things which He is cultivating, then when He comes to us sovereignly as the early and the latter rain, as Hosea 6:3 says, then we shall be there ready and prepared of the Lord to receive those things that He shall pour out freely upon His people in greater works. This is what God will do. It is that power and force of His will prepared for a day and a time and a season and a people that have sought after God, who have not wearied, who have not fainted, who have not turned back, who walked in the word of the Spirit and the Spirit of the word, and did not bend and did not bow and did not compromise, no matter what it took. Hallelujah. This is true. This is true. We do not look on the outward things. We understand we've got an unseen realm that's giving us private information from the chamber of the Father, so that we might know by the Holy Ghost those things that are about to come to pass upon the earth. I tell you, it is a great outpouring of the power of God. It is a great moving of signs and wonders and miracles and exploits like nothing that has ever been demonstrated before. Hallelujah. This is what Father is cultivating. This is what Father is cultivating. This is the precious fruit of the earth that He has long patience for. This is the precious fruit of the earth that He will give no rest until it is produced. This is that fruit which we were called and elected and ordained to have, that whatever we ask the Father, Father will do it. Listen to this. Listen to this. Last night, Daniel and everybody over there in Oregon's watching right now, and last night the thunderclouds started coming in with the lightning. And we've got hay on the ground. And my son began to pray that it would not rain. They had a flood everywhere, all in the Klamath Basin, and beyond. We usually, because of where the ranch is located, we get worse weather than everybody else. It just had a little bit of rain, and that was it. It went everywhere else. Listen, I'm telling you right now, he's just going into that place of walking in the glorious liberty of the sons of God. He dares to stand up in the authority. He dares to go ahead and begin to ask Father based upon a relationship that has been given to us in Christ Jesus. And then that develops, and that explodes into full maturity, full sonship maturity, these works and greater works of the fullness of the measure of the maturity of the ministry of Jesus, even unto a fully matured man. Now, leaving the principles of the doctrine, let us go on unto a fully matured man. Paul said, when you should have been adults, when you should have been full grown, so that you could receive the spiritual meat and revelation of the insights that God would give those who are now going to walk in greater works, you are our children having need to be taught the first principles. We got to get past this. It's been going on for too long. And there's some zealous, hungry, passionate eye of the tiger people in this place tonight. Hallelujah. 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 I'm going to tell you right now, religion and every other thing, every devil in hell runs for cover as soon as God's people start hollering. And I'm going to tell you right now, a holler is going to turn into a cry. A cry is going to turn into a shout. The type that Father cannot ignore. Hallelujah. Because there is a people There's a people. The Lord said, the Lord told me one day, not too long ago, he said, because the prophet lives on the inside of me and comes right up out of me. He said, when are you going to stand up and declare those things which should be in the earth and stop allowing these things that the Supreme Court would do and that others would do and that communities would do and that and societies would do? When are you going to begin to declare my word and my authority? When are you going to begin to possess all of your inheritance? Because you walk on, as it were, as a possession, every realm of the spirit. Hallelujah. Just like Moses, just like Abraham went out and walked out upon the land to take control or possession of all of his inheritance. And even as the children of Israel took a possession by the soles of their feet touching the ground, wherever they went, it belonged to them. So is the realms of the spirit that Father has prepared and given for all of those who love him, for all of those who are hungry and thirsty, for all those who are so desperate about asking that they passionately seek and continue to knock until every one of their requests are received. Hallelujah. Rabataya. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Kanapanahaya. Come on, man. I'm a heavenly man, not an earthly one. I'm a man of the spirit, not a man of the earth. Hallelujah. I'm a God-made man, not a self-made man. I want heaven. I don't want this world. I want Jesus. I'm not interested in demon spirits. I love the realms of the Holy Ghost. I am completely and totally and absolutely given over with total abandonment. God's looking for a people. I don't allow anything that would any way grieve or in any way begin to harass or shut down this flow of heaven in my life. There are as many people who come and they've been touched by the anointing, by the Spirit of the Lord. And he calls them to begin to feel and sense the glories of heaven, the ways of the eternal realm. Hallelujah. They begin to taste of the power of the world to come. And then they went home and continued on in their same manner and their same lifestyle and their same behavior and came back and just began to interact with it as though it was just fun time and play time. And they were trampling upon the high courts of God and the sanctuaries of the Most High, not knowing that in their actions they were hardening themselves against the move of the Spirit. It's time we begin to understand that when we get to touch that realm, when we're touched by that realm, God says hello to us and invites us to come on in and live and remain there, to come on in and have this place as a habitation now, to be taught of God, to learn all the ways of righteousness, to be taught how to walk in the paths of life. It's time we wake up and be no longer children tossed to and fro by every trick of men. God's going to have a people. I was talking to the Lord about this one night. God, how long? Oh, God, why cannot people hear? Oh, God, why is it that people are so dull and are hard against the things of the Spirit? The Lord spoke to me. He said, I am going to raise up an army and not a few. Ha, ha, ha. Ha, ha, ha. I'm going to raise up an army of mighty men and women, not a few. A great, great company. A great company. A great company. A great company. Watch what God does when he begins to do it through a people who waited upon him and sought him and given him no rest day and night until the rain has come. Yeah, he loves the lost, but I'm telling you right now, he purchased a church with his own blood. I'm telling you, he loved the church so much, he gave his life for the church. I'm not changing the church to suit sinners. I'm not changing the church to accommodate the lost. That is crazy. Pentecostal fire turned the world upside down, right side up. It brought down the high places. It brought down the things that had hindered the flow of the glory of God. It changed the earth. Pentecostal fires in a generation. And the same thing is going to happen again. It's going to happen again. It's going to happen again with even greater exploits. Let me read this to you. I'm going to try to read this to you if I can. I get so excited about the things of the Spirit. But many behave as children who are so excited about running and playing that they are unwilling to go to work. That's just a child. Bless their hearts. We love them. Love to see them out there having fun, enjoying themselves. Furthermore, the growth and the moving forward demands change. A change that is brought about by correction, which is once again an interruption to our playtime and enjoyment. And don't we know it? For we've all had the ministry of the belt to the lower part of our anatomy that messed up our joy and our playtime and our entertainment. And so this is the state of the church. However, we must decide what we want. What we want most, to run and play and enjoy things according to our own liking? Or do we want to move forward into that which Father has chosen for us to do? Father, who is the husbandman, desires to produce in our life the fruit of his Son, that the glorious church with all of his authority may begin to shine bright in the midst of a crooked and perverse world. And this is the tension that we're in. And very few ministers, very few, have, as it were, the ability to stand up against the harassment and stand up against the insult of a congregation, because it makes them feel so lonely and rejected, and they just can't take it. To say, no, we're going to do it God's way. You're not going to do it your way. No, we're going to learn how to live under the rod of the shepherd. No, we're going to learn how to live under the rulership of the Holy Ghost. We're going to learn the spiritual laws of life. And you're going to be corrected when you're wrong. And when there's things going on in your life that are hindering the flow of the Spirit to you, we're going to let you know. And we're going to straighten it out. And when there's violations in the Spirit that is grieving the Holy Ghost, which those who are his ministers are very sensitive to. I'm very sensitive to these things. Because I don't allow those things that would grieve the Holy Ghost in my own personal life. How much more has he then prepared me to be able to watch over his house? Because I'm not going to, at the slightest thing that grieves the Holy Ghost, I'm crying out to God, oh God! How much more would I stand in the place and hear and begin to feel the things that would grieve the Holy Ghost and not begin to deal with it? Oh, come on now, people. Oh, and I'm going to tell you, for those who are growing, there's going to continually be correction, because change, correction brings change. Correction is the instructions of the Lord so that we know how to do it right. It's an encounter so that we now understand things more clearly and more definitely of how to do them the right way and not allow the wrong to influence us. People want to try to shut us down. You're not messing with man, you're messing with God when you're messing with his church. During Smith and Revival, the Grays were here with me, and I said, guys, has the Lord stirred you? Because this has always been in my heart, the pluralistic ministry, the body of Christ, revelation, the church flowing in the manifest glory of heaven, Spirit of the Lord being able to move upon each person within the gifts. He said, no, we're not ready for that. He said, there's no government. People won't come under the rule. The spirit of rebellion dominates the church. And I'd ask other dear friends, and they'd say, no, people got to die first. You know, it's almost like words that we would talk about when we're talking about going and doing ministry in Kashmir or North Korea. And I don't know. I can understand what they're saying. All of these guys that I'm referring to have been used by God in greater ways than I've been used. I just believe we've got to be willing to stand up and declare the word of God and not stop speaking the word of God and let it fall and let it shake where it will. Let people decide what they want to do and what they want to choose, because everyone is always at the crossroad of decision to self-justify or to go on to know the Lord. Yes. Everyone. To receive that which God has given. Tonight, Father has things for me and I want to receive them. I want to grow. I want to mature. I got a 10-year plan. I'm now cutting down, getting ready to come into the time point of 9 years. 10 years. I gave myself, the Spirit of the Lord just moved upon me in the gift of faith. And I said, I'm going to step into the fullness of the measure of the maturity of the ministry of Jesus unto a fully matured man in 10 years. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Paul did it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I pause today. The fullness of Jesus was manifested in his mortal flesh. Hallelujah. He stepped into all the realms of the divine glory and the fullness of Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And the Lord wouldn't have said that we could do it and not be available. In fact, that's Paul's plan A. Plan B was you remain as children. It's just like either going to be one of two states. You're either going to be children walking in human mentality and the mental ascent back and forth between self-interest and more self-interest and the interest of the Spirit, more your will than Father's will, or you're going to go ahead and with total abandonment take up your cross and follow him and live only to do the will of the Father and do nothing of yourself. It's rule number one of sonship. It's the law of the Spirit of life, rule number one in sonship. It's a consecration that Papa's looking for. Yes. Hallelujah. Turn me up. I keep weakening. Hallelujah. Now, when you turn it up, you have to always remember what you got to do. You got to tweak the high end. You know, and I'm a pastor. Somebody said, how is it that you can continually tell people stuff? Because I've learned how to do it. I've been doing it for 34 years. You know, the other day, Daniel was calling out to William and a couple of other people were standing around him, Caleb and somebody else, I can't remember, was Gabe. And he says to him, he says, William, come here. And so all three of them came. He said, no, just William. All I need is William. So I stepped out and I hollered across the field. I said, who over there is named William? Raise your hand. They all stopped and William raised his hand. Now I said, the one with his hand raised, would you please come here? The rest stay. People are looking at me. I just said, I've been a pastor for 34 years. I understand you have to say it in so many different ways. It's just the way it works. And Father fills us with patience and long suffering. I got a lot of patience for you. Huh? You're going to have to understand what I'm doing. A great moment of revelation when all of a sudden, oh, we really need this. Whoa. We got to have this. And furthermore, we can't be those who say that we're going to go, say that we're going to function, say that we're going to flow, say that we're going to do the will of the Father, and we don't go. Because he said, then publicans and harlots go into the kingdom before you. And I'm not going to fit that class, and I'm not going to sit around and watch somebody that I think is in danger of that class because the Holy Ghost had put a neon sign over your head, and I'm looking at it, and it's going, danger, danger, danger. And I'm going to say, oh, I'm not going to say nothing. I'm going to say something. I'm going to go, you in trouble. And then you can take it whatever way you want. You can take it as a bastard who does not receive correction. It's not a bad word. It's a biblical word. Or you can take it as a child who delights in correction. Because he knows it's done out of love. Now I know no chastening for the time seemeth joyous. But afterwards, what does it do?
It yields the what? Wow.
Do you want those? Peaceable fruits of righteousness. And I got the proof. I got the proof. I have the evidence. I have the reproducible proof of those who've been willing. Hallelujah. Praise God. And it's to my family first, and then it's to the church, and then it's to those that are around me that God has invited me to go and minister to other churches and other ministries, and now that's picking up. where more and more churches want me to come and minister to them. And I'm saying, okay, Lord, I'll do it at your pace. I'm not ambitious. See, I let God open up doors and send me places just as miraculously as it would be to see the blind eyes open, deaf ears open, crippled walks, lost, truly saved. Huh? Hallelujah. The saints baptized and filled with the Holy Ghost. That's a miracle too. Amen. And so then the Lord said to me, there are also those who despise the chastening of the Lord because they have been taught to be rebellious children and taught in the church. I didn't put this in there, but that's what the Lord taught in the church, to be rebellious children. And by this, they reject the ministry of the Holy Ghost. God's people must hear, for the Lord will not allow those that would resist him and present hindrances to his will and purpose to continue much longer, for he will accomplish in the midst of his people that which he has established to glorify his Son. All that God has purposed his church to be will certainly come to pass, and that which would hinder will be removed. You must understand the sacredness of the realm of the Holy Ghost. And when all of a sudden we begin to understand the spiritual laws of the glorious church, wherein we are all baptized by one Holy Spirit down into one body. And that isn't just something that happens once. That's something that every time you come into the meeting place, is supposed to, you're supposed to submit yourself to consciously and verbally. Amen. They won't just come plop down like this belongs to them. Hello. You in Father's house. You're in a place of authority and government and power and majesty and glory, where Christ Jesus, the Son, is held up as the one who is the total mentality and headship of the place. And the Holy Ghost himself is the life giver and expression of all that takes place. Woo! What happens when people change from a mental ascent, an earthly ideology, a religious philosophy, traditions that spoiled them, and begin now to walk in the rudiments and ministry of Christ Jesus and be established in him? Papa's laboring to bring it forth, and he's going to labor through me, and he's going to labor through his ministers, because that's the way he set it up. Jesus Christ took all that his authority, and he baptized his church in the glory and handed off the work of the ministry to his church to do the things of the earth that he himself, by model and example, showed us that was the will of the Father to do. And everywhere he went, the sickness and the disease was healed and cured, and sin and wickedness was overthrown, and every work of Satan was destroyed, and he gave us power over unclean spirits and authority to tread upon all the power of the wicked one. It's about time we move in. But you're going to have to stop the human mentality, the self-interest. You're going to have to come into a place of surrender and say, Father, I live to do your will. I want to be taught of you. I want to understand the spiritual laws of life. I want to walk under your rule. I want to understand how to move in your currents. I want to understand how to move with the Holy Ghost. Hey, I'm going to tell you right now, easiest thing to do is to hear the Holy Ghost. You're just going to have to shut down all the other voices. And the loudest one in the program is yours. Self-interest is the loudest screamer in your life. Listen to me. Hallelujah. I know firsthand. Because every one of us have to deal with the same exact things if we're going to move on with God. So, why don't you say from this day forward that you are completely given over to the Holy Spirit to walk in the Word of the Spirit? Why don't you just say that? Why don't you just go ahead and receive the gift? And quit acting like you somehow you got to earn it, some works of righteousness with you. Why don't you just receive the gift of the Holy Ghost and just begin to honor God and say it's mine and start rejoicing in it, giving thanks. And every time the liar comes along and says you don't have it, you get up and dance around a little bit and rejoice in God, your Savior. You let the Holy Ghost come upon you and you begin to get excited about all that God has done.
Huh? Come on, man.
I'm talking about a heavenly people that the world cannot understand. The world cannot know us. Everything about us is foolishness. And as long as you're trying to romance the world and impress iniquity, you don't even have a chance of standing in the glory. The carnal mind is hostile against God. It's at enmity against him. It is his enemy. You're going to have to learn how to go ahead and embrace yourself, embrace meekness and lowliness, and understand that's where you begin to move into a realm of surrender and submission and yieldedness. Hallelujah. God's going to fight against, he's going to war and battle against those who are prideful. He gives grace to the humble, but the proud, those who say, "You're not telling me. Who made you the boss? I know as much as you know. You don't know anything about God except for after the Spirit. You need to become people of the Spirit. Then you'll have a different attitude and a show on your face. God's purpose that your face glow with his glory. Inside, your heart's going to have to start glowing first. Then your face will glow.
Hallelujah.
Ha, ha, ha. Your thoughts are going to have to come under the control of the Holy Ghost. Ha, ha, ha. Then your eyes will shine with the brightness of his presence. Hallelujah. 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 Your heart's going to have to become a treasure chest of his word. Then your mouth might utter choice words, beautiful words, words of the Spirit, the sound of heaven being now revealed through your mouth and your lungs. Praise God. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the name of the Lord. Man, I feel like stretching out a dance for you here. Praise God. But it really won't be for you, you see. It really isn't for you. I hardly know you're here. You know, I just every once in a while look up and recognize what God's doing, what God's saying. Hallelujah. Because I'm caught away in the realm of glory. I'm ahead away in his presence. I'm raptured. Hallelujah. And God wants to rapture you too. And then keep you there. Huh? Somebody said, "Oh, they don't believe in the rapture." I get raptured all the time. I believe in the rapture. I got raptured today. I got raptured yesterday. Ha ha. Caught away in the Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There'll be one day there'll be a group of people, God said it, he's revealed it in his word, that will not see death, but they shall be caught away. I personally have faith and confidence in that if I should be alive at that time, that I'll be one of those people that will not see death, but will be changed in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, shall be caught away. Hallelujah. Yeah. I don't have faith for hanging around when, see, people don't realize that the book of Revelation is the revelation of Jesus. It is the revelation of how Jesus feels about sin and iniquity. It is the revelation of his wrath and indignation upon all ungodliness. People don't understand. They understand because they're taught wrong. But let's come into the school of the Spirit. Amen. Hallelujah. We're going to have a school of the Spirit on Friday night. And I'm going to unveil some things to you by the Spirit. Amen. That if you'll do them, if you won't just hear them, but you'll go and do them. Hallelujah. Like you would labor. For those of you who want to get a good grade, you just can't stand to make anything less than an A. You got to stay up all night to get it. You'll do it. Huh? Then you begin to respond to God's word with the same kind of passion and interest. Ha ha. Ha. I'm going to tell you right now, then that means that you've grabbed a hold of the Word and you've allowed the Word to begin to produce within you something that is only possible because you are hungry and thirsty and willing to participate. Then the good Word of God produces the fruit of His Word. Hallelujah. But if you don't earnestly desire, if you don't sincerely desire the good nourishment of the Word of God so that you can grow, and that really is, the sincerity is all about willing to do it. I want to hear what you want me to do, God, because I'm going to do it. I know that I've got to do these things. I know that obedience is going to result in the outpouring of your glory and the maturity of your grace in my life. Hallelujah. I'm trying to get done. I'm still at the introduction. See, I have been trained by a different school. And I love it, man. Sometimes I'll be going through the old catalogs of the old-timey preachers, and they'll be preaching those same messages that God gave me, and it just encourages me so much. I don't feel like the oddball anymore. Hallelujah. Even though I got to go back to the 30s and the 40s to hear it. Praise God. I get to take up the torch from the 30s and the 40s. That's fine. Hallelujah. I love to be able to read in the scripture and not feel like the oddball when Paul was preaching so late that Eutychus, he's only known for falling asleep in a church. He got known for something, but my goodness, I'm going to look up Eutychus right away. Somebody said, who are you going to look for in heaven? Eutychus. Dude, you fell asleep in the meeting. Paul was a long time preaching. He fell down dead. Hallelujah. Fell out of the window. They went down, raised him up from the dead, and continued preaching until the morning. And then they went, then they got up and went to the next city. Hallelujah. That's called got a burning fire, hot coal from off the altar of God on the inside of your belly, and you can't be quiet. There's a lot of work to do. There's a lot of maturity that has to come to pass in the life of God's people, and it's only going to happen because the Word of God is preached, and the Spirit of the Lord goes forth with the Word of God and produces a miracle result in the life of those who are hungry and thirsty and zealous and passionate. You can live in this world if you want to. You can carouse with demon spirits if you want to. But I only want God. I love heaven. I don't like hell. People say, well, God is God, the loving God. He's just going to take all of us. Well, if God's the loving God, going to take all of us, heaven would be hell. And we're not going to live in hell. Praise God. There's not going to be murderers and rapists and you know, haters and liars and thieves and demons. Praise God, and death and shame and disease. Disease is the touch of death. Hallelujah. Just like healing is the touch of resurrection life. Hallelujah. And it's wonderful, you know, when you begin to understand that you got resurrection life just pulsing through you. Same Spirit, Holy Ghost that raised Christ Jesus from the dead dwells in you. He not only quickens your immortal body, but everybody else you touch. Hallelujah. And there's been so many proofs of it that we should be so built up in faith by now that we should all be running around, you know, raising the dead and everything else. I'm looking forward to ministering at James Levesque's church up there in New England. He's actually got the building that all the great preachers was in, Jonathan Edwards, George Whitfield, all the great preachers was in it. And while we're there, I think it's Friday night and Saturday morning, David Hogan's going to be ministering. I've never met David Hogan, but God's used him in a special way to raise a lot of people from the dead, just in a special gift to raise from people from the dead. And then I'm a minister Saturday night and Sunday morning. But, I mean, I get so excited about that, you know. People just go ahead, take a hold of the power of God. And then the person that was one of the most influential persons in David Hogan's life, his son's going to be here on Sunday, Joel Stockstill. I believe David Hogan actually either got saved or came into Pentecost in Joel's dad's church, in Joel's church. So Joel Stockstill is going to be here along with his dear wife, Amy. We love them so dearly. They're part of who we are. We tied together, you know, in this holy alliance. Hallelujah. I'm telling you right now, people say, oh, what about all the division in the body of Christ? Hey, how about all the unity in the body of Christ? We got a great company of people that we join arms with all around the world. I'm telling you, we hearing the same things, speaking the same things. I'm telling you right now, we submitted to one another and the things. We bouncing all these different things off of one another and hearing God together. Hallelujah. It's wonderful. You don't feel like the oddball when you're hearing so many people saying the same thing about here's what God's doing. Here's what we need to be doing. We got to hold the force of it. We got to hold the press of it. We can't let up. We can't be Laodicean and start pleasing the people. We're going to have to please God. It don't matter what the cost is. You need to count the cost. If they stone you, if they kill you, if they tar and feather you, it doesn't matter. If they call you the devil, if they said it about your master, what they going to say about you? Hallelujah. And you got to be willing to stand up and take it like a son of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Woo. Hallelujah. You hear that? You hear that? Got to stand up and take it like a son of God. Amen. Amen. Like an heir of God. Hallelujah. Ha! The reproaches wherewith they reproached him has fallen on me. Come on. You watch what God's going to do in your life. You watch what God's going to do in the midst of his church. Yeah. What he'll do through your life if you're hungry to be in the midst of the church. If you want it his way instead of your way. When you start realizing, I don't care how smart you are in the human mentality. I don't care how smart you are in the rational, logical things of men. It has no bearing whatsoever. The greatness of the wisdom of man is foolishness to God. It has no bearing at all within the framework of those things which belong to the Holy Ghost. Those things which belong to the Father. You've got to unlearn that you may relearn. Hallelujah. And the only way you're going to unlearn is to start saying that you start hungering and thirsting for a new kind of knowledge. Hallelujah. A new kind of understanding. And in that new kind of knowledge, you don't want the old kind of knowledge. So you get rid of everything that tries to exalt itself against this new kind of knowledge, this knowledge of Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This knowledge of the Spirit. And I'm going to be here to help you. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ha. And I'm gonna speak the truth in love. And I may be hollering with passion and intensity in the Holy Ghost that my veins are popping out of my neck. But I'm gonna tell you right now, at any moment I could just stop and start joining in the Holy Ghost. I start dancing around. I could start moving in joy unspeakable full of glory. Because it's the same realm. Just say, people, oh, my daddy used to holler at me like that. Well, he didn't holler at you like this. No, he did not. He hollered to you through a demon power in his life. I'm hollering at you through the Holy Ghost. And the Lord wants to give you ears to discern. I had some people come sit in the meeting and say, well, we'd come to the meeting. We have other people we'd bring. But we've all been abused by our fathers, and you yell too much. I said, well, what is it that you want in the first place? Are you looking for the move of God or that which suits your interest? You want God according to your fashion and your understanding. You can't have God like that. You can't have him like that. Father's not going to change. It's going to be his way. Just go ahead and to always give yourself, listen to this. Why, I'm going to say this again. Why don't you just say from this day forward that you are completely given over to the Holy Spirit to walk in the word of the Spirit, to always give yourself to joy and rejoicing, especially in the house of the Lord, which should be unto you a celebration and an unusual interaction with the Holy Ghost. You start honoring Father's house the way he described it, and he's going to honor your house. Amen. I'm going to tell you right now, the Lord says it over and over again, there's going to be joy in my house. You can't come into my courts without joy and rejoicing, without thanksgiving and praise. I'm not going to have a sad countenance in my house. I'll give you over to your enemies if you're going to have a sad countenance in my goodness, I heard that and I said, I'm never having, so I'm going to rejoice in the Lord. I want you to dance and sing and shout and praise. People just want to get an offering so they can get rich. They've reduced the glory and totally down and monetized it. Hey, I believe in the wealth of God. I believe in God's blessing upon my finances, but it's in direct proportion to the spiritual, the soul blessing. Hallelujah. I don't want any other kind of blessing. I don't want you to have any other kind of blessing anyways. And I want us to be able to give an offering to Father and the kind of praise and the kind of worship that he's looking for in spirit and truth. And it's described with joy unspeakable and full of glory. It's described as rivers of love. Hallelujah. Out of rivers of peace. Hallelujah. Rivers of thanksgiving. No condemnation. My. Hallelujah. But peace. Peace is the opposite of condemnation. Jesus said to those that are near and those that are far, peace be unto you. In other words, he removed condemnation. He didn't say draw not nigh. That's condemnation. Did you know that we are under the ministry of righteousness? Hallelujah. We're under the ministry of righteousness. Hallelujah. The ministry of righteousness. God's screaming at you and telling you you're righteous. And you're going, no, I'm not. Yes, you are. No, I'm not. Yes, you are. Now start behaving that way. It's a gift. Now start walking it. It's a gift. Now understand the rules of it and the laws of it. Understand the function thereof. Understand the power of it. Understand the glory of this thing. This weapon you're holding in your hand is mighty. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Some of you got it on safety and can't get it off. We want to show you how it operates. We don't want you living it on safety. We want you to step into the unlimited realm of divine glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, I post these things on my Facebook because the Spirit of the Lord, that's what I'm doing now. I only have Facebook as a ministry, as a forum for ministry. And I just wait on the Lord's God. I mean, I want you to do what? Follow me. I've got anointing in my life. I've got a gift in my life. You can have it too. And you begin to honor it. You'll come immediately under it. And I don't care how you function in the Holy Ghost. It'll begin to become unique as it's hooked up with the things that God has supplied in my life. And I'm going to stay hooked up with a whole bunch with the body of Christ and all the plurality of ministry and the diversity of ministry that the Lord has in his house. I'm going to tell you right now, we're going to have an uninterrupted flow of all the streams of divine glory. Amen. Yeah, we are. Come on, man. Get on in the big middle of it. Hallelujah. Get in the center. Let everybody lay hands on you. In the spirit, so to speak. You know what I'm saying? I love the anointing, you see. And when you love the anointing, oh, you're so sensitive to the anointing. You honor the anointing. Well, I don't care where you see the anointing, you cleave to it. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I was watching a dear sister minister today on the old YouTube. And I'm telling you, as soon as she started preaching, the anointing hit me. I just started weeping. She was weeping, and that's years ago. I mean, you know, the anointing is just there. It's just there. It's just on a YouTube, and it just still comes because it's conveyed by the word.
Hallelujah.
Conveyed by the countenance, by the vessel. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. If you would give yourself to rejoicing and thanksgiving, delighting in the word and in the presence of the Lord, you would understand the mind of Christ and the way of the Holy Ghost. Now listen to me. I left out of here on Sunday night. And of course, I have had an extreme passion for the past 4 months of seeing God's people everywhere I go, whether it's here or elsewhere. And sometimes when it's elsewhere, the people don't know me, and it's just easier. I mean, I had the Baptists, people who never even believed it, that thought tongues were of the devil, standing in line to be baptized in the Holy Ghost inside of 3 days in an 8-day meeting. Come on. And you got to watch out because you stay under the anointing, you start taking it for granted. Huh? And you won't begin to react, and you'll get stagnant. You'll stop. Or you can believe a lie and be damned. Believe a lie and miss out on everything that God is doing. In other words, be entrapped by the lies or the deceits of Satan, the powers of darkness, influence of hell. And I'm just praising. I'm praying. I'm saying, God, show me, tell me, show me what I can say to the people. Show me how to say it in different words. Show me, oh God, what I can do. Lord, for so many of them are earnestly hungry. Oh, Father, what is it going to take? And when I left on Sunday night, I was just crying out to God. Just crying out to God. I couldn't sleep. Crying out to God all night. Just crying out, God, what is it going to take to break people out of the stuff that they're in, out of the lies that they believe, out of the hindrances and the influences that they've come under? What is it going to take so that they can move on? Father, you raising up an army. Show me what can we do? Lord, show us. Show us. And the Lord gave me this. The Lord, by within 24 hours, By Monday night around 9:00, I was walking around Monday with an amosateama, a moratea pakete, a godosane kikanakasatai, a mantle of his glory and of his power on my life. And then by 9:00 that night, the Lord gave me this. And I'm telling you, that's if you'll do this, if you'll do this, you will understand how to flow in the Holy Ghost. If you would just give your, it's just so simple that you don't allow your members to come under the oppression and the subtlety of self-interest and ultimately under the influences of a demonic influenced world system, which can be communicated to you by much of the programming that goes on in commercials and television. You're going to have to be careful what you watch there. You've got to be careful what things you're taking into your bosom, what you're communing with. How can you sit there and commune with all of these things and think that you're walking in the mind of the Spirit and the mind of Christ? Wow. Give me a break. Long hours people spend completely offline doing things that belong to this world of self-interest. I know that we need to go to work, but you can walk with a skip all day long and do your work excellently. Yeah. You can walk with a joy and a rejoicing. Yeah. You can walk with all day long rejoicing in God your Savior and not getting wrapped around the axle of stress and earthly concerns. Come on. You can give yourself to the Lord. That's why that I was telling you about that study on Sunday where, you know, they were talking about where that men at most are happy 20% of the time. That's the upper happy folks. That's well-dispositioned people. 80% of the time, they're sad because they don't feel they're good enough parents. They don't feel they're good enough at the job. They don't feel a good enough husband, a good enough wife, on and on, not good enough at anything. Talk about a culture of condemnation. We don't live in a culture of condemnation. I have a culture of correction and instruction. I am a highly disciplined son of the living God being taught to walk in all the ways of God. If you don't think there's a need for a lot of correction and instruction there, you need to think again. You haven't really believed the report of what's been made available and the dramatic changes and the dramatic shifts and behavior that need to take place in your life. Hallelujah. Walking in the Holy Ghost is a 24-hour-a-day job. I would rather say it's a 24-hour-a-day blessing. But it is a conscious participation. It ain't happening passively and without your participation and saying, oh God, I yield myself to thee. I love you. I want to be taught by you. And meditating upon the word. Meditating, in other words, reciting it, the scripture says, day and night. Hallelujah. Huh. That's just Old Testament. That is just a ministry of condemnation. Now it's in our heart and in our mind. He's established his thoughts on the inside of me. So now when I read the word and I begin to rehearse the word and I recite the word, it's living word on the inside of me. Hallelujah. Now, I don't have any dead letter. It's all by the Holy Ghost, the Spirit that gives life. No dead letter here tonight. Didn't know if you noticed. Don't know if you didn't notice or not. We have no dead letter here tonight. Dead letter that's commanding you out of your own human ability to get right. I'm talking to you about living and walking in the Holy Ghost and depending upon the power of God to be everything that he's purposed and called you to be. He just wants to fill you up. This will redeem the times. There's nothing else that's going to redeem the times. Redeem the time, for the day is evil. Don't be drunk with wine. We got a sign out there on the highway. It says, if you're buzzed, you're drunk. See, the world's got more discernment than the church. If you're practicing getting buzzed, you're a drunkard. Read and weep by way of repent. Intoxication is an influence of demon spirits. Whether it's the smoke of marijuana, that is, listen to me now. I really don't need a commentary. Whether it's the smoke of marijuana, it is the influence not of some chemical or physiological response to some, you know, chemistry. It is a demon spirit. Same way with alcohol. Same way with heroin. Same way with methamphetamine. All of it, same thing, same demon power, same witchcraft influence. Came right out of the same hell. Oh, yeah, it did. And you'll never know how to flow in the Holy Ghost and be filled with the Spirit so long as you sip or imbibe that demon spirit. That thing will have to be broken off of you. Huh? In fact, if you fully yielded to the Holy Ghost, you'd probably vomit something out. No, I mean, it's just that gross. Because there's nothing so demonically occupied as someone who's been born of the Spirit allowing demonic activity in their life. And I'll tell you right now, you drink of the good waters of the Spirit, you won't want that stuff anyway. You'll feel the devil on it. You'll feel the demon spirit on it. Somebody said, how do you know? Do you have proofs? I have proofs. Because I have laid my hands on many people who were alcoholics or intoxicated with drugs, heroin, marijuana, alcohol, methamphetamines, crystal meth, other things, cocaine, and cast the devil out of them, and they immediately became sober. I said, in the name of Jesus, you foul spirit of hell, I command you to leave now. And they're completely sober. Hello. And not only have I, but I've got a whole list of preachers who got the Holy Ghost, who are given authority over unclean spirits to cast them out, who walk in the ministry of the Church of the Lord Jesus Christ as is taught in the good word of God, that will tell you the same thing. Huh? People want to sit around and sip on wine, get buzzed on wine, because they don't know how to walk in the Holy Ghost. Because they've never tasted of the good waters of the Spirit. Because all they got is religion. All they got is sensationalism. They walk after the five senses instead of walking after the Spirit. They mind human mentality and have a mental ascent in their praise. It's strange fire. It's not even Holy Ghost fire. That's why there are many times where I go into a place I don't want them to worship. Because if they start worshiping, I feel the strange fire, and all I got is just, it's a reproof. It's all I got. You want me to hear me preach? You want to hear me preach? Because I only preach by the Holy Ghost. I don't know. I can't preach by myself. I preach under the inspiration of the Holy Ghost, and it's reproof because it's strange fire. So I just wait and don't let them do any music until we get a move of God going on. Hallelujah. And go ahead and do some music. Huh? There are times, and I know other ministers of the gospel, I'm not an oddball on this. This is something that I have a witness and testimony to in a broad cross-section of God's ministers. Huh? Because we're not interested in creating a church business and just attracting people because we got it all figured out. We got excellence of professionalism. I want excellence of Holy Ghostism. Amen. Amen. Of moving in the Spiritism. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'll take a donkey any day declaring the word of God over the best professionalism there is. Hallelujah. I'll take a crow cawing praises to God over the best voice of human mentality any day. Come on, man. Come on, man. It is a place of not performance. I'm so blessed. You know, Joshua just gets up there tonight. I mean, just like, come on, labor and let it flow. Come on, let that anointing flow. Spotanea. I know it's a little hot in the place, and I realized I was going to be laboring long in the word. Papa wants to meet your needs. He wants to supply these good things of heaven. I mean, I've got so many more things to say just about those that I haven't even read all to you that the Lord gave to me. That if you'll do it, you'll begin to flow in the Holy Ghost. But I have it posted on my Facebook. And some people say, well, I don't do Facebook because I can't handle all the rest of the stuff that's around there. Well, go ahead and walk in the Word and move in the Spirit and rejoice in the living God, and you'll have the victory, and you won't have a problem. Amen. Huh? You'll see that immorality and holy indignation arise up in you instead of some kind of demon influence wanting you to go over there and undress her. Or whatever. Give me a break. Foul stuff. Haven't tasted of the goodness of his delights. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The good word of his Spirit. Hallelujah. The beauty that is in his presence. The pleasure that is in his presence. Come on, man. Come drink deeply of the waters of the Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. It isn't going to be much longer that we'll continue on in the, you know, having Ichabod written over much of the church with an undisciplined, fat, blind Eli laying down in his blindness. Huh? In despondent spirit. Let God do whatever he seems good in his own eyes. He didn't fall down and repent. Oh, just let God do whatever seems good to him. That's what Eli said. And his two boys forcing the women, laying down with the women at the door of the tabernacle. Because Papa's got had some Samuels been laying down in the holy place. I'm one of them. Hallelujah. Been laying down in his presence. And he's got many of us all throughout the earth. A lot of us in the United States of America. A lot of people who've not sold out. Amen. Hallelujah. Somebody told me, he said, you're antiquated. You're like from the dark ages. You're like a Renaissance medieval person. I said, no, you ain't gone back far enough. I'm back 2,000 years ago in Christ Jesus, man. Hallelujah. I'm all the way back in the first century church. Amen. Amen. Having matured in his government now. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. I want to minister to some people here tonight, but I'm just prompted by the Lord just to, you know, I wrote down these verses of scripture. I'm just prompted by the Lord just to read them to you real quickly. And it's Isaiah 55:2. Hearken diligent to me and eat that which is good. He's talking about his word going forth. Hallelujah. 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 Porasananea. Hallelujah. And let your soul delight itself in the glory. Huh? That's why we want you to understand how to behave yourself in the house of God. Hallelujah. We want you to do things decently and in order. Okay? Decently and in order is to be ecstatically joyful in the house of the Lord. Amen. That's decently and in order. Ha. It is just, it's joy unspeakable and full of glory. It's love like, I mean, overflow. It's a heaven. It's the manifest glory of God, the manifestation of the Spirit given to every man decently in order. Praise God. That's decently in order. This is what the Lord's saying about how you should respond to the word, how you should be constantly joyful. I mean, I tell you right now, people, if you'll hook up, if we will agree together in the things that God has spoken, there won't be able to be one power of darkness stand against us, not one sickness or disease be able to stand up in the presence of the church of the Lord Jesus Christ. Not one person will be able to walk in here bound with the devil and bound with sin and the blindness of sin and be able to continue on in it. Because of the glory that is in the house. Isaiah 58:13. The Lord says, do not turn away your foot from the Sabbath or my rest, from doing your pleasure on my holy day. He says, don't do your pleasure on my holy day. And call my rest or my Sabbath or my meeting place a delight. The holy of the Lord, honorable, and shall honor him, not doing your own ways. Not finding your own pleasure, not speaking your own words, then at that place you will delight yourself in the Lord. And I will cause you to ride upon the high places of the earth, and I will feed you with the heritage of Jacob. Hallelujah. That's the kind of wealth I like coming to me, you see. That's prospering and being in health even as your soul prospers right there. Huh? That's it. That's what Father wants. He wants that hallelujah coming out of you. He wants that Holy Ghost move. That's a Holy Ghost move. See, that just ain't your throat right there. Huh? Hallelujah. That ain't just you trying to be happy to please the pastor so he don't tell you to get up and dance. Ha, ha, ha. That's just being over in the Holy Ghost. That's just being over the things of the Spirit. See, if you'll just read Romans chapter 8. Romans chapter 8 talks about the Holy Ghost more than any chapter in the New Testament. He's talked about 20 times in one chapter. And by and large, Romans chapter 8 gives you the rules of walking in the Holy Ghost. That those things that will cause you a faith and ability to yield, and those things that will get in your way and hinder you from flowing. It ain't hard to get one chapter down. Amen. Then I got a whole commentary. It's been sitting there on the web for the past 20 years. Well, not quite that long, but I mean, goodness Christ, I've been breaking this stuff down a long time. Hello. Yes. You know, knock, knock, knock. Man, when the Lord's standing at your door, knock and open up. Yes. And you'll receive that which God is speaking. His word's not going forth as empty words. His word's not going forth as vanity and that which will not profit.
His word goes forth, empowering and giving life. His word goes forth, creating those miracles which he has ordained. For God said, and it was so. Every creative thing he ever did, even as he does it tonight, all you have to do is shut down your human mentality. All you got to do is quit relying on your ability to figure it out. All you have to do is quit saying, oh God, what's wrong with me? And start singing and rejoicing and giving thanks and delighting yourself in the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ha. Harabakona say. Well, just let me, let me just get the pile driver out and just drive this thing in just a little bit further. Yeah. Psalms 37:4 says, delight yourself also in the Lord. Delight yourself in the Lord. Delight. Hallelujah. And you know, it's more, it's different from rejoicing. You can't just cover delight by rejoicing. I'm telling you right now. Delight is like eating such tasty things that you're going, oh, wow, my, this is good. We invited a guy over to the house to eat one time, and he embarrassed all of us. He was going, I mean, every bite is like, this is expressions of delight, because it's good. My wife cooks good. It's good. I mean, amazingly good. We have to be highly disciplined. Hallelujah. Ah, delight. And the word literally is that which refers to the enjoyment of dainties. Those special, delectable, tasty things that causes your whole being to respond and go, my, that's good. Ah. That becomes your response to his word, to his presence. If the joy and the rejoicing, if you'll quit allowing the oppression of an antichrist spirit of disobedient atmosphere to impose itself upon you, because you won't allow it. As soon as that begins to happen, you get up and dance. You get up in joy. Give thanks to the Lord. You get yourself right back over there looking unto the rock from which you were hewn, looking unto the author and the finisher. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on. If you'll do these things, you'll understand how to move in the Holy Ghost. You'll understand how to walk under his rule. The mind of Christ and the mind of the Spirit will soon be yours. You'll no longer be making decisions out of your own judgments and ideas, but the word of knowledge and the word of wisdom will come unto you. The understanding of the holy will be yours. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, the Lord showed me that I began to preach on the fear of the Lord many years ago, but one day I was in that place, in that room, in that glory realm with the Father, and he said, listen, the fear of me is to be captivated by my presence and be in a mouth-dropping awe state over who I am. Would you like to see? My heart burst in the inside of me. Yay! God. Yes! Oh God! Yes! Let me be in awe of you. See, that's different. Be in awe of him, you will not sin. Hallelujah. Ha, ha. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of the wisdom. The awe of him, the beauty, that which causes the seraphim to with two wings, they fly. Hallelujah. That which moves all heaven and earth at his glory. Hazabananea. You know, baby, I'm getting kind of thirsty too. Huh? We love you. You know you're going home with Papa and Mimi tonight. Huh? Hallelujah. We're so excited. We get to keep the grandbabies for a week. That's just cool. Being grandparents. Hallelujah. You know, Ann and I have set ourselves to live a good old age. A good old age is defined as 175 in the life of Abraham. But we believe that there should be great signs and wonders in these last days. We ought to be all wrinkled and puckered up and look like some kind of prune, I tell you. I want to be with the Lord, but there's a lot of work to do here. I understand myself to be a link between the past and the future. I carry upon myself the responsibility of the church of the Lord Jesus Christ now and in the future. Somebody said, that's God's responsibility. I'm heir with him. I've taken up Father's business. Hallelujah. I take a personal responsibility, not busy about doing the other stuff. Thus, I'm not all entangled in that stuff.
that people have to battle and don't understand how to walk in the glory because they don't have a heavenly vision. They got too big of an earthly one. They're all wrapped up in the cares of this life. If you step over in this place, there's a great divine provision for you. There's a great divine protection. Oh, there's a great divine perfection for you. Oh, there's a great divine ministry. Come on, don't miss out on this. Don't miss out on this. I'm telling you right now, it's all this in heaven too. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Psalms 48, I delight to do thy will. Oh, my God. See, Genesis, the mystery of sonship, it is written of me. I delight to do thy will, O God. Hallelujah. There in this ministry of sonship, he has anointed us with the oil of joy above all our companions because we in him, we get what he received. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, man. Psalms 119:24 says, the testimonies, your testimonies, Lord, the utterance of your word, and this is said over and again, your commandments, your statutes are of my delight, and they are my counselors. Ooh, yeah. Come on. Listen, we want you to just begin to interact with this word like that after the spirit. We don't want you to hear the word after a human mentality and after a mental ascent. We want you to begin to move and function and live and walk and breathe in the Holy Ghost and be led under the authority, under the force of him, so that the word which is spirit and life can have influence and impact in your life. Amen. And bear forth fruit. Amen. Hallelujah. And then, hallelujah. 1 Thessalonians 1:6, and ye became followers of us. Hallelujah. And the Lord, having received the word in much affliction with joy of the Holy Ghost. She needs me. She needs me. She needs me. She needs me. Here, just hold this up. I'll take this, and you take this, and I'll take that. Come here, darling. Oh, I know. Papa's just preaching so long. Now in Jesus' name, you're going to have no sickness on you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Psalms 89:15. Blessed is the people that know the joyful sound. Hallelujah. I got a sound going on here tonight. It's the word of God being uttered by the Spirit of the Lord, gushing up out of my innermost being. It's the nabo to bubble up that produces the nabi, the sound of the prophet. Hallelujah. Blessed are the people, because there's many people that don't know in the name of Jesus. You're not going to have no stuff on you. And blessed are the people that know the joyful sound. They shall walk, O Lord, in the light of your presence. You want to get in here? You want to get in here? Come on, man. Start responding to the word. Call his word a delight. Cease to speak your own words. Stop doing your own will. Stop walking in your own way. Call his holy things a delight. His men, his anointed ones, honorable. Hallelujah. Then shall ye delight in the Lord. And then he shall cause you to walk upon your high places and feed you with the good heritage of Jacob. In thy name they shall rejoice all day long. And in thy righteousness shall they be exalted. Everybody stand with me.